Dear students, welcome to EPG Paathashala program. Today we are going to see the subject class, which happen to be the part of aesthetics and fine arts paper. I am Professor Thyagarajan, the head of the Department of Sanskrit from Presidency College, Chennai. The term kala has got different connotations in Sanskrit dictionary. Kala means the digit of the moon, the rays of the sun, a fraction, and arts. Today we are going to see this particular kala as an entertainment, an art. Kala here, with regard to literature, refers to the entertaining part, a sort of visualization of what you have in your mind as a creative force, and also the presentation which entertains others. Kala means a creative force, first of all. Kalayati means he is creating something. So this kala is addressed to always to goddess Saraswati, because she happens to be the goddess of arts. As if remembering this, Kalidasa is versifying the kalas in one of his stanzas, eulogizing goddess Saraswati, where he composes poem, Kamala Kamalaja Kanta Karasara Datta Kanta Karakamalakam Karayugala Udrita Kamalam Vimalam Kamalanga Chuda Sakala Kalam. So when he says Sakala Kala, that means it's all arts. But when you say all arts, then you have some sort of ambiguity. Our ancestors, ancient people, have already understood what are kalas, and in the later period they have enumerated it also into 64. In this module on kalas, we will know the antiquity of kalas, the importance of kalas, and the various types of kalas, and the concept of kalas, whether it remains the same or it is modifying according to the time, etc., you are going to see. Kala and Lalita reflect the culture and civilization of any country. India, with its remarkable sculptures, paintings, architecture, dance, and music, has always been a wonder to the world. Fine arts, which existed in ancient India, reveal that they have had the origin in the Vedic period. Indians have always had the tendency to attribute the origin of any shastra, of any such work, to the ultimate or the god himself, along with a mythical story. It is said in Kalika Purana that the kalas were born along with bhavas and havas from Sandhya, when Brahma experienced the feelings of love for Sandhya. Vedic hymns, while describing the dawn, that is the Ushas, goddess addresses her, that is Ushas goddess, addresses her as a dancer dressed up beautifully in different colors. She, the daughter of the day, is a beautiful girl dressed suspiciously and always dancing. This shows the high esteem in which dancing must have been held in Vedic period. The concept of Tvashta and Vishwakarman in the Vedas help us to get the origin of painting, sculpture, and architecture. The person who models the form is called Vishwakarma, the beauty, feminine grace, etc. also. He is Tvashta. This is revealed by the sentence in Rigveda Samhita, and one that appears in Taittiriya Brahmana. Again, in Taittiriya Brahmana, there comes a reference in which Tvashta is called as Rupakrit, one who makes the form. The word which denotes a sculptor in later literature. Rigveda compares Tvashta to a wood carver fashioning various forms. Tvashta is the creator of powerful weapons of war again. He is the one who made the Vajra and gave it to Indra to kill the demon called Vritra. He is also the creator of exquisite jewels for ornamentation and the golden jewels designed beautifully. In Rudra Adhyaya, the Lord is addressed as a chariot maker, wood carver, a potter, and a metal worker. These clearly point out the active work in wood carving, clay work, and metal work, selecting of ore, carving, making jewelry, weapons, vessels, etc. are well known in Vedic period. Though many people argue that there was no idol worship in Vedic period, we get many references in Vedic literature which show that idol worship had its base in Vedas only. In Shadvimsha Brahmana, there is a reference to the murtis in the temples. These temples may probably be referring to the Devamanas mentioned in the Rigveda. The abode of Yama, constructed by Devas, is mentioned. Rigveda says that Devamana is an exquisite type of building desired by men for themselves. With these, we can conclude that Indian architecture, sculpture, and iconography have developed from the Vedic description or the murtis of several deities and the Devamanas and the elaborate yajnasalas mentioned therein. Model making was well developed in Vedic period. Samvidhana Brahmana, a line talks about the dolls, elephants, horses, chariots, etc. made by duff. The earliest conception of Indian arts is creating forms with a due measure, revealing and concealing the vision of eternal truth. The word Shilpa is found in many places in Vedas and Brahmanas, but its meaning is slightly different from one which occurs in classical literature. Aitreya Brahmana says that Shilpa is the refinement of the self. Kaushitiki Brahmana says that Shilpa is threefold, consisting of Gita, Vadira, and Nritya. The word Shilpa that occurs in Shatapatha Brahmana stands for the art of modeling, painting, etc. As per the commentary of the Sayana, in Chandogya, one of the earliest Upanishads, the list of arts and sciences has been mentioned. The artistic insight of our seers is seen from the exclusive and elaborative construction of yajnasalas and vedis, that is altars, which looked in different patterns from an aerial view. Saman is a song based on Rigveda. The singing of Samaveda is of various kinds. There are songs for the villages, songs to be sung in the forests, and songs called Uha and Ukhya. In a ceremony such as that of Mahavrata, dance, singing, and instrumental music are combined. In the later Vedic literature, the different notes on the octave are clearly mentioned. From this saman, the Gandharva Veda or the science of music has developed. Bharata attributes the origin of Gandharva to lute and the flute. In the Vedic conception of beauty is inseparable. Vedic conception, beauty is inseparable from goodness and the vision of truth. The hymns to dawn show that to the seers, it was the expression of divine glory, conformity with the divine law. The Upanishads identify beauty with rasa. See, in the Puranas also, like Vishnu Purana, Bhagavata Purana, you find the mention of arts. In the Bhagavata Purana, you find Balarama and Krishna as a learning the 64 branches of arts in 64 days. In the Ramayana of Valmiki, there are mention about kalas. in few places. Mahabharata says that Shiva taught Ganges the 64 branches of fine arts. Apart from these many of the descriptions in these works, we find the arts like dancing, music, sculpture, painting, polity and statecraft, etc. They are seen in a highly developed stage. The art of dancing and acting had developed well with the time of Panini, the ancient grammarian, where you find the mention of Natya Sutra by Shilalin. With these scriptures also, you find the mention of fine arts. Art is what gives rest and lucidity to mind according to Buddhist literature. There is a work called Lalita Vistara, a Buddhist work, where you find the mention of 86 kalas. The same work, it is also said that Buddha was equally good at the 64 kama kalas. And there is another work called Jatakamala, which mentions kalas. And Jaina scriptures also, the Kalpasutra, Aupapadikam and Prashna Vyakaranam, etc., have mentioned 72 different kalas. In the Mahabhashya also, you find the mention of kalas. There is a question: are the kalas like her mother or not? See, this sentence indicates the development of kalas during Patanjali's time. Dandin, an author of Dasakumara Charita, describes the hero as an expert in the 64 kalas. There is a great prose romance by name Kadambari, written by Banabatta. He also describes one Chukanasa, a prince, as having expertized the kalas. There are many poets talk about kalas, and especially Kama Sutra talks of many kalas, and Vamana, Magha, Bhavabhuti, Bharabi, and other poets also have some way or other in some of their works mentioned about the kalas. And mostly all the kavyas are mentioning about the kalas. And the Kama Sutra particularly explains how a person is well esteemed in society if he knows the kalas. The work of the great poets like Kalidasa, Magha, Arsha and others stand testimony to their sound knowledge in all the branches of kalas, that is fine arts. See, we can never say that the kala has, the development of kala has reached its saturation. It can never saturate. It is always developing because it is a creative force. If you think that the kala has saturated, then you should know that the world has come to saturation. So it is always dynamic. It always keeps the world going, moving forward along with its people. Generally, people think that kalas are many, but they have enumerated it to 64. The term Chatushtashtikala, Chatushtashtikala Aradhya, is also mentioned in the Lalita Sahasranama, where there is an address to Goddess Parvati. Though the enumeration of all the 64 arts is not found in the books of Vedic and Puranic literature, commentators on Bhagavata Purana have described the kalas, but they have not given full account of it. See, there is only one authority on kalas, that is Vatsyayana's Kama Sutra. And the commentaries on that also mention about it. There is a book called Shiva Tattva Ratnakara, written by Basavaraja of Keladi. He has enumerated the 64 fine arts and discusses in detail about the fine arts. But there are many deviations of the list of arts mentioned earlier. Of course, his collection encompasses all the fine arts. Dear students, you will know now that how kalas have developed right from the Vedic age. So, Vedas have sown the seed for the development of arts. And later on, based on the culture, the society has picked up the kalas and they have been developing it, and thus they have enumerated the kalas into 64. And we will be seeing what are all the kalas and what actually they signify and they actually present before the audience for the sake of entertainment. And kalas, when you say, they are not static as we have already seen, it is always dynamic. It is evolving every now and then. The process of evolution takes place depending upon the time. Therefore, it is possible that there may be certain deletions of arts, certain additions of arts, certain arts being developed to the further stage, etc., have been going on in the stream of life of people in the society right from the Vedic age. You have in the Sukra Neeti Sara and other works also the mention of kalas. Next, as I told you, the concept of kalas ever changes. The enumeration which we are going to make now is based on the Kama Sutra, which is a standard text dealing with the 64 arts. Now we will see one by one what are all the kalas. First, Geetam is one of the 64 arts. Geetam is music. It is tuning, the composition, the timing, and the appeal, etc., as told by Yashodhara, the commentator of Kama Shastra. Next, Vadyam. Generally, we know what is Vadya. Vadya means it's an instrument. Four types of instruments, that is stringed instruments, beating instruments, repercussion instruments, blowing instruments. These are respectively represented by Veena, Mridanga, Talavadya, made of metal and flute. Then Nrityam. Nrityam, everybody knows, because it is a part of the dance. It is Karana, Charis, Angaharas, Vibhavas, Bhavas, Anubhavas, etc., and the depiction of rasas through dancing. Alekyam. Painting has, Alekyam means painting. It has got six parts, that is Rupa Beda, Pramana, Bhava, Lavanya Yojana, Sadrishya, and Varnika Bhanga. So different types of painting. And then Visheshaka Chedyam. This is called Patra Chedyam also. Then Bhurja Patra, that is the leaves of Bhurja tree, are cut in different designs and applied as Tilaka over the forehead. This is also an art. Then Tandula Kusuma Bali Vikaraha. It is just like making kolam at home. It is made of rice flour. So it is just rangoli and other things which we are today calling comes under this section, Tandula Kusuma Bali Vikaraha. Next, Pushpa Taranam. See, you are making the bed with the flowers in the houses or in the temples for the deities. Then, Dasana Vasana Angaragaha. So, this is, nowadays you can say, is a textiles. In the textiles, you have got the dyeing of clothes, etc., with the different colors. And we apply lipsticks, etc., also. And we are polishing our teeth. So, these are all coming under this particular Dasana, Vasana, अंगराग देन मणिभूमिका कर्म सो मणिभूमिका मीन्स इट्स इन द फ्लोर यू आर जस्ट स्टडिंग द ज्वेल्स इन डिफरेंट पैटर्न्स एंड मेकिंग इट अपियर ब्यूटिफुल सो इट इज यू आर नॉट ओनली दैट यू आर मेकिंग द फ्लोर कूल जस्ट लाइक मोजाइक और टाइल्स विच यू आर लेइंग टुडे दिस टाइप ऑफ आर्ट इज ऑल्सो नोन टू द एंशियंट पीपल which they called it as Manibhumika Karma. Then Shayana Rachanam, this is also an art. See, making, it is just like housekeeping nowadays. So making the carpet clean and beautifully, you can decorate with the cushions, carpets, etc. in the house. So that also requires a sort of skill. So whenever you are talking about kala, a skillful creative presentation of anything is called kala. Now udaka vadyam, that is another kala. So it is just like jalataragam, a vadyam which we are nowadays able to see, that is vessel filled with water, you are playing with that, making noise out of that. Then udaka ghatam, it is a play on the vessel of the water, vessel filled with water. And at same time, you are splashing by hands or by mechanical devices. Then Chitra Chayogaha, that is art of performing wonders. Something like magic, you are doing it, or something you are making. Some people will say will twist their hands in a different pattern, which others cannot do. So in kala, in how you are able to entertain when the audience are not in a position to do as a person does. At same time, he exclaims or the wonders upon the action done by the kalajna or the entertainer. Now, malya granthana vikalpa, this is also an art. So, you should know how to create garlands, rosaries beautifully with different patterns. Then, Shekharaka Pida Yojanam, that is, even binding of turbans and having some caps, everything, and top knots over the head, these are also a sort of pattern, likable to others, entertaining others. It is just like the different types of hair cutting today in the modern world. Then, Nepatya Prayoga, see, according to the occasion, this Nepatya is always attached to the dramas where you should appropriately dress yourself according to the situation, according to the occasion. That is also an art. Then Karnapatra Bhanga, that is making ear ornaments on ivory, conch, etc. Then Gandha Yuktihi, see, preparation of perfumes, oils, etc. also is an art. Then Bhushana Yojanam, that is, you should know how to decorate yourself with different kinds of jewels and making use of it to different parts of your limb, body. Then, Aindrajalaha, there is purely magic and sorcery. Anything you do as magic. Then, Kauchumara Yogaha, that is, which gives success in many affairs which cannot be performed by usual means. So, they got a mantra, tantra, everything. And make it may look magical, but it is somewhat realistic also. And Hastalagavam, see, it is a manual skill, magic also. And anything you do with your hands, making people to wonder, is called Hastalagava. Then Vichitra Shakayusha Bhakshya Vikara Kriyaha, that is preparation of food, that is also an art. So, what is there is of different kinds, there is bhojya, bhakshya, lehya and peya, of four kinds. This is meant even in the Bhagavad Gita, that is pachamyannam chaturvidam. Krishna says that I am just making four types of food. Then panakarasa raga asava yojanam, That is panakam, everybody knows it is a sweet water prepared out of jaggery. And in that also you add so many condiments which add to the health as well as the perfume. If somebody gets attracted towards the preparation of such things, that is an art. Next, Suchivana Karma, that is sewing. Sewing also you got different types. And embroidery, everything comes under that category. Then Sutra Krida, that is with the threads, they make different kinds of shapes and flowers, everything. This is called Sutra Krida with thread. Sutra means thread. Then Veena Damaruka Vadya. So the playing of Veena and Damaru. Damaru is also a drum. So you are attracting the people through different types of sounds. Next, Prahelika. It is making puzzles. You are just creating some puzzles and then making people to answer it. That is also an art. And then Prithimala. So saying verses with the akshara which came at the last of the verse recited by the previous person. Nowadays we call it as antyakshari. That is also an art. Then Durvachaka Yogaha. So it is very difficult to playing on words. That is, you are making a rare word instead of the common word. For example, Ulukajit for Indrajit. Indra has a synonym as Uluka also. So you say, instead of telling Indrajit, you say Ulukajit, making people to surmise what actually he is telling, though he means that. Then Pustaka Vachanam, even reading also. Generally, reading, how can it be an art, people may think. See, in reading, the ordinary way of reading, and then reading with intonation, reading with music, reading with a tune, all these things are also an art. Then Nataka Akhyayika Darshanam, that is a presentation of a drama. And also, for example, the dramatic representation of the stories of the past. Then Kavya Samasyapuranam. See, somebody leaves two lines, rather he composes two lines and then leaves the remaining thing for others to compose. If the another person could compose, then you call it as Samasya Puranam. Puranam means filling up of other two lines. Then Pattika Vetravana Vikalpaha. That is, you Pattika means it's a box. So making boxes with mats, cords, etc. That is also an art. Then Takshakarmani, making jewelry, you making with the metals, you create certain ornaments. That is coming under this category. Then Takshanam is carpentry. Everybody knows that. Then Vastu Vidya, that is architecture. So then Rupya Ratna Pariksha. That is, you are able to test the gems and then the silver, gold, everything is being tested. So, that is Pariksha means it's testing, examining that. Then, Dhatu Adaha, the extraction, purification and the alloying of minerals, ores, metal and jewels. These things are called Dhatu Adaha. Then, Mani Raga Akara Jnanam. See, knowledge of mineral deposits from surfaces, that is coming under this category. Then Vrikshayurveda Yoga is purely agricultural matter. You know how to make a garden. It is gardening and nurturing the plants, etc. And then protecting the plants from the diseases. Then Mesha Kukkuta Lavaka Yuddha Vidhi, that is cock fight, then ram, male sheep, sheep fight, etc. And Lavaka is a sickle. So the fight is also an art. Then Chukacharika Pralapanam, then teaching the parrots and other birds, sometimes even dogs or any animal for that matter, these things are coming under that Chukacharika Prahelanam. Then उत्साहने संभगने केशमर्दने च कौशलम. कौशल मीन्स इट्स अ स्किल. दैट्स वाई आई ऑलवेज से दैट कला मीन्स अ स्किल. वेयर इन संभगने केशमर्दने सी अप्लाइंग ऑइंटमेंट्स अंगेंट्स टू द हेयर परफ्यूम्स मसाजिंग एंड ड्रेसिंग अप द हेयर्स एंड मेकिंग अ हेयर स्टाइल ऑल आर कंसिडर्ड अ स्किल कमिंग अंडर दिस कैटगरी. देन अक्षर मुष्टिका कथनम. हियर पीपल मेक डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ साइफर्स और डिफरेंट स्ट्रोक्स एंड देन मेकिंग यू टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई हैव रिटन एंड ऑल. सो समटाइम्स दे राइट समथिंग इन दैट और समटाइम्स दे गिव ए सिंबॉलिक रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ व्हाट दे वांट टू कन्वे. देन म्लेच्छित विकल्प दैट इज टॉकिंग सम जॉर्गन्स फॉरिन जॉर्गन्स and then they change the voice also, change the forms. So those things coming are coming under that category. Then desha bhasha vigyanam. See, knowing different, not only languages and also the dialects, according to the place people have their own expression of their thought. Such things are coming under this desha bhasha vigyanam. That is regional knowledge, regional languages knowledge. Then pushpa shakatika, that is making flower carriages and cars. You are decorating the cart, chariot, nowadays cars, etc. Then nimitta gyanam, this knowledge of astrology, that is shakuna. We say while you see something that something may happen, this people may say it is beyond any logic or reason, but however the belief always exists. So such things are, if somebody knows that something will occur after observing something going on, then it is called nimitta gyana. Then yantra matrikaha, that is machineries, that is all animate and inanimate objects. When somebody knows that, then that is an art. And dharana matrikaha, see, it is dharana. Dharana means remembering, recollection of things. Somebody immediately, at one stroke, he understands it and he is able to repeat. So ekachandagrahi, dvichandagrahi, like that you have got different types of people who can easily grasp. At one expression, they can grasp that and then repeat it. And some people may just think twice, thrice, and then later on they understand that. That is an art. Then sampatyam. See, it is very much like antyakshari. It is also completing a sansa. Left out, anything left out, they complete it with their knowledge. Then manasi kavyakriya. See, some hints are given and he composes the poem on that. That is manasi, manasika composition. Nabidana kosham, that is learning of the lexicon. If a person knows a lot of words and meanings, then that is also an art, because everybody cannot remember everything. And it is said that Shakespeare knows 1 lakh of words. And chando jnanam, that is knowledge of meters, the composition. You must be a poet to compose things. Then kriya kalpa, see, theoretical knowledge of composing poems. So you should know what are the characteristics and what are the need for composing a poem. Then charitaka yoga, that is disguising, concealing the true appearance. Next, vastra gopanam. So it is wearing the clothes without making others understand that what he wears is a torn clothes. Then dyuta visheshaha. So it is knowledge of gambling. Next, akarsha krida, that is playing with the dice. Then bala kridanakani, that is games for children with the balls and dolls. Then vainayaki, the art of courtesy. So you should know how to offer hospitality to your relatives. That is also an art. Then vijayaki, it is the art of victory. So how to create success, So that also has got a sort of thinking, a skillful thinking. So that comes under the management of things in our day-to-day life. You must note that there is one art called Vyayamiki. There is exercise, yogas, gymnastics, etc. are also mentioned in the 64 class. From the study of these 64 class, we understand that kala is or inherent for some. For some, it is trained, given training. For some, it is developed by their own. So, without kalas or the entertainment, man cannot live happily. So, kalas are meant for the sake of creating happiness in the human being. Because nowadays, people are living with full of stresses and strains. For them, a sort of entertainment is required. Without entertainment, the mind will not become ease. So, to ease the mind and to create happiness in the heart, the kalas are very, very important. And under these kalas only, we find the modification or the development in the form of cinemas with a cultural base, with the dance, music, and the projection of human thought through the films, etc., have become important. Therefore, the art is essential in the life of a human being. And not only that, even I understand the animals enjoys the kalas, because if you observe the animals around you, they also have got the sense of appreciation for the way that they have been playing with each other. The birds also. So, it is to ease your heaviness of heart in this day-to-day world full of strains, full of anxieties and worries. To get rid of the worries, kalas are the means, are the vehicles in the life, which is the kalas are to be nurtured, and then they are to be given prominence also in everybody's life.